Okay, here we are. We're going to take a ride on this 2015 BMW R1200. We'll take a quick road trip and kind of give you our first impressions of what this bike is all about. It's pretty robust. Comes with all the bells and whistles. 125 horse. Got almost an 8-gallon gas tank. Kind of a good looking bike. So there you are. This is a 2015 R1200 GS adventure bike. Little view over the cockpit. Here's your GPS, cruise control, ABS brakes, almost an 8-gallon gas tank. Comes with all the equipment. You've got the saddlebags that go with it. Guards on the side. Super bright lights. Yeah, this bike is just ready to be rode. Well, here we are. We're gonna take a drive up Casper Mountain here. This bike has got gobs of torque. I can't believe we're having 2 cylinders, how powerful it is. The minute there, I thought I was driving Harley. It's a nice easy cockpit, easy to look over while you're driving. GPS is in a nice position, you can see it very easy. All your controls, finger controls. Operate your GPS from the handlebar. Really kind of nice. Mirrors don't vibrate. We have 125 horsepower. This thing has got just gobs and gobs and gobs of torque. We're at roughly 5,600 feet right now. We're going to go up to about 7,000 or 8,000 feet here in a short bed. This bike falls like it's on flat. It's kind of nice. I kind of like it. It's really hard. When you look at this bike, it looks really big and bubbleless, and it's, I don't know. It gives you the wrong impression. As soon as you get on it, it's agile, it's got tons of power, rides like a dream. I mean, it's just the opposite of what your first impressions would be. I can just picture myself doing tons and tons of miles on this bike. It's ultra, ultra smooth. And I think you've got to get lots of tickets with it because the ride's so smooth, so nice. Pretty hard to tell if you're going really fast or not unless you get down the speedometer and then it's too late. We're setting a full elevation really quick. And they say 15 mile an hour curve. They're not far off. Brakes on this thing are really nice. The engine braking is really good too. Power on this. It's nice being back on board one of these Beamers. It's been a while. Corner is really nice. And bear in mind, this is not my bike, so I'm not going to run it real hard. This is really kind of nice. A few really sharp turns on this road, eh? day here. That's kind of wild, eh? But you should watch where I'm going. Gotta watch the houses. This transmission is just flawless. It shifts so easy. With the popular lookout right here on the right, you can oversee and look at the city of Casper and Evansville. We'll just keep on going. Cruise on up the hill here. Yeah, it should be getting pretty cool here in a little bit here. Nice living on the side of this little mountain where that guy's got his house. Good luck, truck. This thing in third gear and it just doesn't feel like it's even working. But it's the first time I drove this bike and I just got out of it a little while ago, so I'm being a little cautious with it because, like I said, it's not my bike and no sense going up the side of a mountain that you're unsure of yourself. I can feel my ears popping, so we've got to be gaining elevation. This thing is just so smooth. It's got a couple different seat adjustments on it too. I put the seat down low just for something to do, see how it rode. It's really kind of nice. Puts you down a little bit lower. You're down a little bit underneath the front windscreen a bit. The front windscreen right now is adequate. And I got to crank up as far as it'll go. But I'm kind of thinking that on a long trip, it wouldn't really keep that much air out of you. Kind of wild. Casper Mountain. I just take it easy coming up down here. The sheriff likes to sit up here, so no sense giving him something to talk about, eh? And I see the lodge is for sale again. This is such a smooth bike. I can't believe for having two cylinders how smooth it really is. You think it'd be a lot more rougher, it wouldn't idle as good, but it's just, there's hardly any vibration in the hand and grips at all. I can't think of anything I'd better be on right now than coming up here cruising to the top of this mountain. That little squirrel. Yeah, this thing just comes on. It's really kind of nice. I can imagine this thing is just built 75-80 on the highway, just cruises effortlessly. And I bet you the gas mileage is as good as what they say it is. So my first impressions, I like it. I mean, it's really super smooth. The ride quality is some of the most comfortable seating positions that I've had. I've been on some bikes that aren't even close to the ride of this. This is really nice and soft. You can adjust your shocks, your ABS and everything to suit the road conditions. I've got it on road right now, so it's kind of nice. I could put it for a little bit rougher conditions, but why bother? You know, this is perfect. This bike is liking this third gear here. little bit of rock on the road, so take it a little bit easy. Even though this is an adventure bike, I don't want to be taking an adventure into the grass. Well, I have to thank the owner for letting me have this bike for a few days to do a ride review on and work on it a little bit. I really appreciate him. And it's good payment for working on the bike. So I guess you think about it, would I own one of these? Oh yeah. Do I need one? Nah. But I'd own one. You know? If I had to do any kind of long distance touring on rough road, I'd do this in a heartbeat. This thing is just super fun to ride. It's not a cross rocket, not a road rocket, but it's surprisingly really agile. Now, it definitely had third tires on it, and I'm not going to whip it down the dirt road right now because, like I said, the bike's not mine. And it's practically brand new. I just did the service on it for the weekend, so in my mind, this bike's not even broken in yet. It's kind of a fun ride. You can do this. This mountain range right in front of us is called Muddy Mountain. We're just coming down off of Casper Mountain. Cruising down the road here. A lot of places for sale, I see. Oh. Looks like a little bit of construction going on. This road is kind of fun up here right now, this time of the year, but in the wintertime, it gets pretty snowy up here. You can only go a little bit farther up the road here, and then it's closed. So. Nice view up on top, though. Real nice view. Both of these mountains here in Wyoming are like this. You get up on top and you can cruise across the very top of the mountains. And it's just a really fun experience. I gotta take it for a little ways down this dirt road. Just to see what. That's the cool thing about this bike. When the pavement stops, you don't have to stop riding. It's kinda nice. It's skittish, but if you don't gotta do a lot of road riding like this, you'd change the tires on it. You know, I'm out of the road, the tires are running now, they're good for street and street only. I wouldn't trust my bike to run up and down these roads without having any issues. Well, beautiful ride. Beautiful, beautiful ride. Yeah! We got the tourists up here. Well, I'll just pull over here and turn around. Another biker up here enjoying. And that's a cool view of Muddy Mountain right there. There you go. That's basically my ride. There you go, that's the 2015 BMW i1200 GS Adventure Bike. First impressions? Awesome. Nice bike.